This week's edition of the Overtime, we will take a look at the updates with Coconino football season and look into how they will climb the ladder in the Grand Canyon region. Then we'll look at NAU cross country and how the men are dominating this season. Welcome to this week's edition of The Overtime. I'm Taya Morrison. Joining us today is reporter Lindsay Ringway. So glad to see you with us today.
I'm so glad to be back on the show, Taya. Let's not waste any time. Just get right on into it.
Coconino started their season off strong with a four-game winning streak that was broken last weekend when they lost against Prescott 34-28.
The Coconino Panthers loss to the Prescott Badgers was their first Grand Canyon regional defeat since 2018. Despite junior running back Cooper French putting up an impressive 212 yards and four touchdowns, the Badgers rushed just 28 yards more than Coconino. That included 130 yards by junior Cody Leopold, along with his two touchdowns, which included the game-winning touchdown in overtime. Though the Panthers put up a strong first quarter, things began to fall apart as their offense failed. The Panthers' running backs just could not find enough holes in the Badger defense, and going into overtime, though the Coconino hoped to secure a win but eventually fell to Prescott with a one-yard score. This loss ends Coconino's 16-home game winning streak, but moving on from this loss, the Coconino Panthers will host number 34 Mingus Union on Friday for their final regular home game of the season.
Yes, now let's get into NAU cross country. NAU men's cross country placed first during the Florida State Invitational last week. Also, big individual champions Abdi Hamid and Taryn O'Neill took the title and will be moving on to the Big Sky Championship on October 29th. The cross country team seems to be upholding their reputation as one of the best in high elevation.
Despite that, things did not start out great for the men as they began to fall at the start of the race this past weekend, but quickly picked up the lead by the 3K mark and continued that lead for the remainder of the race. Redshirt junior George Cush, as well as redshirt sophomore Thayer Quacks, placed 20th and 25th along with that. The Lumberjacks had three All-American top finishers, with redshirt sophomore Abdi Hamid Nur finishing in fourth, while sophomore Drew Bosley and freshman Nico Young followed close behind in sixth and ninth place. For the women, Taryn O'Neill was on fire as she finished fourth overall, placing herself as the top women runners in the country. Following behind O'Neill was junior Bryn Morley, finishing 53rd. While when the smoke cleared, the women finished seventh place, bringing in a total of 279 points for the Lumberjacks. The Lumberjacks will be back at it again on October 29th for the Big Sky Championships.
Hannah went out to the McPherson Disc Golf course to interview Nick Allen.
All right, guys, as you can tell, I am not in the studio today. I'm actually at the Disc Golf Club here, and I'm with Nick Allen, the president of the Disc Golf League. Nick, can you tell us a little bit about this team and where, how you guys started, and how you kept the legacy going through these past years?
The club's about 20 years old, a little bit older than 20 years. I've been a part for a long time, not too active until recently. I'm actually the current president of the club. So we've been active since, I think, 1998 is the original, and then a couple of our founding members got together around 2001.
So Nick actually gifted me these discs, so I'm very excited. Yeah. I was wondering if maybe we could get out on here.
Yeah, absolutely.
And you could show me. Okay,
indeed.
I would like to just point out that I have played disc golf with friends before.
Okay.
But I was very bad. It was something we did at quarantine because we quarantined together, but I always lost the frisbee, so I kind of got booted out because... I can never manage to keep it in play, so I'm hoping maybe that you can tell me a little bit about your techniques and show me how it all works.
Absolutely. I'm just going to stand and deliver, so I'm a little injured right now, but
okay.
You want your arm down the fairway right, and you want that disc to finish right to
okay.
The left. So I'm going to walk up a little bit.
Oh, wow. Gosh, I don't even think I'll ever get that far, but that's talent right there.
Indeed. So you want to stay more in the fairway than I did, and that'll be a good finish for you.
I'm left-handed, guys, so I'm going to be turning away from the camera, but let's see what I got. Okay. So, like, do I want to move with my body a little bit?
Yeah, you want to use your hips to engage, right?
Okay.
From your foot to the end of your tip of your hand. Excuse me, this foot. Sorry, you're left-handed, right? So,
ooh.
Tip of your toe to the end of the whip, and you want to whip that hard and finish it.
Okay.
There it is. Fairway shot. Nice.
How was that, everybody? Was it good?
Thank you.
Awesome. So, the technique is just... whether you're throwing it forward or you're throwing it out, and it just depends on where the actual
where the basket is, or in this case where the trees are. If you can see some of these first trees, they dictate where that disc is landing for you.
Awesome. And then I was just wondering if maybe you could tell them a little bit about how you can join, what social media platforms. Do you guys have a website?
Sure.
All that stuff. All contact information.
Absolutely. Home base is flagstaffdiscgolf.org. That's where we have all the course maps, all the details about the leagues. We've got a new calendar we'll be updating for 2022, but all of our events just finished within the last 2 weeks.
Okay. And so for the viewers who are interested in this, what would you recommend for them? How can they get involved? If they want to join a league that's competitive and stuff like that, what are the requirements that you guys look for in some of your players?
Absolutely no requirements.
Okay.
Come out and play. Bring a disc. If you don't have one, most of us are carrying 30 of them. And like I showed you, I've got two extra for you right there.
Yeah.
I've always got some extra in my truck. Anybody's welcome. My son, he's 10 years old. We've got a new contingent of children. Like I said, new women's leagues and women's tournaments coming up too. So.
Awesome. So I actually heard there's an incentive a part of this, so you can chip in some money if you'd like, and you could actually win if you win the contest.
So if you want to play some of the leagues, like the big league that we had, there's a money up front, so there was no round-based winnings. But for leagues like Tuesday, Saturday, and Sunday right now, you can throw in $5 to compete in the league, and then you get a $1 ace pot. So anybody that hits the ace will win that ace pot. It was six days a week. We're now running about 3 days a week just with the seasonal change and things ending.
Awesome. Well, if you guys are interested, you could check out their Facebook social media, or you can look at their website and contact Nick Allen, who is the president of the Disc Golf League here. That's all we have. Back to you guys at the desk.
Hannah, that throw was something interesting, to say the least. What was it like learning from a professional?
I'm all in, and I just might have to join their league next season.
We'll see you after the break. Stay tuned for the debate.
I don't remember how it started.
Start to that.
Our back and forth. It always came back. You probably don't remember what you told me.
That was perfect.
But I heard every word.
Multiple studies have shown that marijuana can slow both driver reaction
and response time, which can be really dangerous.
He's here.
He's here. Wait. What?
I can't drive.
But why?
My.
Oh.
Did you know dragging chains can spark a wildfire?
Only you can prevent wildfires.
Welcome back to the OT, guys. We are now here for our debate between Lindsay and I. Our first topic for the night is going to be NEU football and RJ Martinez as a freshman stepping up to first-string quarterback after Keandre hurt himself his first game of the season. What's your take on that?
I think RJ Martinez has done a great job, especially as a freshman, to be able to step up and carry this team thus far. With him at the top, we've had just great leadership shown. He's really taking the team another step far. We've really been killing it, and he, I think, is getting the confidence he needs to be able to keep taking this team far.
Yeah, I agree, but you know, Keandre did transfer to NAU to play his last couple seasons here for NAU and be that first string quarterback. Mm-hmm. I understand he injured himself in the first game, but you know, people can recover and come back and still play the same. I know that RJ Martinez reads the field really well. He connects with his wide receivers and running backs, but I still feel like Keandre deserves that chance to prove himself and come back and not just take RJ Martinez as that first string and just ride with him for the rest of the season. I feel like Keandre kind of deserves that chance.
I think at the end of the day, it was just that when they needed someone, RJ Martinez was there. He stepped up. He is a freshman. He is a true freshman. And he just kind of stood out to the coaches. They put him in. They trusted him. He went all the way, and at this point I don't see him going anywhere anytime soon.
Yeah, and it's fair to say that, you know, RJ did recently, it's not all him but the team altogether,
right,
but they did win 59-35 in one of their mm-hmm. most recent games, so that does say a lot about RJ, and I know that they're going to carry the team through a great season. So moving on to our next topic, we are talking about NAU Dance and Cheer, how they used to be a part of NAU Athletics and now they are stepping down to being a club. I know as a former dancer myself, it is a little bit of a disappointment to see them step down to a club, just because as a dancer, I see it as a sport along with cheer. And of course, those had to be the first two teams that stepped down to being a club now.
Yeah. No, Hannah, I agree with you. It's something that's extremely unfortunate that they don't get recognized as a technical team anymore, but essentially a club. But as per NCAA rules, for every one men's sport, we need a women's sport. And so as unfortunate that it is that they were the first ones to go, they are one of our not as high ranked sports. And as of right now, they're just a club, but I hope that they still continue to support the teams as we continue to support them.
Yeah, I mean, that is fair to say. At the end of the day, cheer and dance go out to a lot of NAU events and a lot of our games. They do cheer on the team from time to time, and, you know, they do also compete as well. So as long as they're just getting that recognition and they get to do what they love, that's all that really matters.
As long as nobody stops them from doing it, I hope to see them back as a team soon.
All right, well, that's all we have for the debate, but stay tuned after the break for your preview report with me.
Wow, these are really good.
You act surprised. Practice makes perfect.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who don't need perfection. They need you.
I just found out my work party is a plus one. You want to go?
This is my boss, Ella.
Nice to meet you, Greg.
You're welcome.
Nope, I'm high. But I'll clean the kitchen while you're gone.
You're already making good decisions when you're high.
Pool party at Jesse's. Can you drive? I'm toasted.
Nope, I'm high. But I can order us a ride.
Don't make an exception when it comes to driving. If you feel different, you drive different.
This year, patriotism shouldn't just be about pride of country. It should be about love. Remember that to love America is to love all Americans, because love has no labels.
Welcome back to the Overtime, guys. My name is Hannah Ware, and I'm so excited to be back on this show. If you guys missed out on the homecoming experience last weekend, don't worry, because we do have a lot coming up this weekend as well. The Coconino Panthers host the Mingus High School football team at 7 tonight. Their season was running hot until their latest loss against the Prescott Badgers. You could watch these two teams face off or head over to the NAU Sky Dome, where their rival team, Flagstaff Eagles, will hit the field against the Bradshaw Mountain Bears. Heading into some Big Sky sports, NAU Women's Volleyball hosts yet another home game at 1 p.m. on Saturday, where they will start the second half of their conference play. Later in the evening, you can listen to Lumberjack Radio or tune into ESPN Plus as the football team travels to California to play Sacramento State. NAU soccer team is joining the football team in the drive to Sacramento as well. They need to keep up the 4-game winning streak if they have any hopes of holding on to heading to championships. You can watch these girls play on ESPN Plus at 3:30 on Sunday. Well, that's all we got for this weekend, but back to you at the desk, Taya.
So glad to host my first Overtime show alongside reporters Lindsay Ridgeway and Hannah Ware. That's all we have for today's show, but you can check in next week with yet another edition of the Overtime. Make sure to follow us on YouTube, Twitter, Instagram, and as always, have a great night.